What we do in the Global Innovation Index is provide a ranking, which always attracts a lot of attention, of economic performance and innovation performance and capacity. What is important is the particular profile that is given of each country and its innovation capacity in terms of inputs to the innovation process and outputs. That provides a benchmark for policymakers around the world to see in what ways their performance may not be as good as it could be, and in what ways they can improve their policy mix in order to improve innovation capacity and performance. We do, however, notice that in the rankings there are some significant movements this year. In particular, we see that the Netherlands, for example, rose from 9th place to 3rd place. We see that Israel rose 4 places from 21 to 17. China significantly rose from 25 to number 22, and that's very significant because the first 20 or 25 highest performers in the Global Innovation Index tend to be industrialized, developed countries, Europe, North America, Japan, of course. And what we see with China is, for the first time, a middle-income country coming into the mix of high-income countries in terms of innovation performance, and a steady improvement all the time. We also notice that the United Arab Emirates has gone up for a significant number of places, from 41 to 35. Vietnam, interestingly, has gone from 59 to 47, and India has gone from 66 to 60. So the traditionally static nature of innovation capacity being predominated by or predominantly found in the developed countries is changing, and we see signs of that. Countries shouldn't expect that overnight they'll go up a large number of places, although I've just given some examples of countries that have. Generally speaking, innovation is a long-term process, and it requires time and effort and a policy mix which produces results over a longer term. This year we've chosen agriculture, or innovation feeding the world. Why? Because there are a significant number of pressures on agriculture at the moment, starting with population growth, which in turn affects land availability for agriculture. Also climate change, which affects land suitability for agriculture, and alternate uses of lands. And we have these huge metropolises around the world, concentrations of people that need to be fed. Innovation, in all its various forms, innovation developed else in other sectors of the economy, but also specifically for agriculture, offers a lot of possibilities for improving agricultural productivity and improving the possibility for us to be able to feed a growing world population.